Okay, so this video is for AMP2. This is going to be the human torso model, and I'm going to go all the way through all of the internal organs. So let's start at the top with the respiratory system in number one. So the first thing is going to be the nostrils or the nares. And then on the inside, number two, this would be the nasal, the inferior nasal conchi of the nasal cavity. So inferior nasal conchi. Three, the nasopharynx, it's way up in there. So the part of the throat that begins at the nose. Number four, that's gonna be the thyroid cartilage of the larynx. So it's on the larynx. We saw that on the larynx model. Five, right here, is the thyroid gland. Six is the trachea. Seven, I need to take these off here. We'll put them back on in a moment. Gotta get the heart here. Okay, so here's the trachea, breaking off into two primary bronchi. And here you have secondary bronchi where they branch off. That'd be eight. Okay, so there's several parts of number nine. Put these back on real quick. So we're gonna start with the right lung. So this is gonna be the superior lobe of the right lung, the middle lobe of the right lung, the inferior lobe of the right lung, other lobe. So let's go on the left. This would be the superior lobe of the left lung. And it doesn't look like it's on here. This is the inferior lobe of the left lung. May have fallen off there. That'd be this one. We are not naming the fissures in the lungs, so don't worry about those. And then way back up here, back to the throat, this would be the hyoid bone. Now let's move into the digestive system. So we're back up here in the top of the throat area. So this bony portion, this is the hard palate, number 14. And where that ends, you get the soft palate. That'd be kind of, you know, the back of the throat, back of the mouth, roof of the mouth. 16 is the tongue. Everybody's gonna get that one right. 17, these are gonna be the parotid salivary glands. I can't put my finger on it. Parotid salivary glands. 18, these are the sublingual, the right under the tongue, salivary glands. And 19, these are the submandibular salivary glands. So the mandible will be going right around here. So right under the mandible. All right, number 20. We need to get the lungs out of the way now. This is the esophagus going down there. 21. Here, this is where the esophagus actually penetrates through the diaphragm, and this is called the esophageal hiatus. Oh, I didn't say on the respiratory. This is the diaphragm. So this is the diaphragm. Missed that, I apologize. So that's the dome-shaped muscle, important for breathing. Okay, back to digestive. Okay, we have the spleen. The spleen is located on the left side over here. Next, we have the stomach. So this would be the stomach. Everybody knows that. 24, may not have the number on it, but here's the liver. This is the liver. 25 is the gallbladder. So remember, this is gonna be green, green for bile. So there's the gallbladder. I'm going to leave that out now because we're going to have to get more internal. I have the 26. Oh, yes, 26. Here's the pancreas. And then let's go down into the small intestine. So coming straight off of the stomach, you can see there is the first portion of the small intestine. This is a duodenum. I'm losing now parts of my large intestine. This is the jejunum, so kind of like the guts kind of area there. Okay. 29, at the end of the jejunum, is the ileum, so this is the end of the small intestine. 30, this is mesentery. So this is just the connective tissue that's helping to hold and wrap and line all these internal organs together. 31 is the appendix. So I think I'm gonna have to take this portion out. So the appendix is right here. It's this little kind of finger-like portion right beginning of the colon or the large intestine. All right, 32, this would be the large intestine, just in general. So we have 32, large intestine. So it's going to go several ways. So we're gonna talk about next the regions. So yeah, here's the large intestine of the large intestine. So that's gonna be pretty important. So this is the cecum. So the appendix is on the back of the cecum. So there's the appendix. So here's the cecum. And then we go up. This is the ascending colon because we're going up. So we start the cecum. This is where we get the end of the ileum comes into the cecum. Then you have the ascending colon. And then we go across. This would be the transverse colon. E, this is the splenic fixture, so this is the gap, the curve there, and it's right under the spleen anatomically there, or flexure. 32C, I guess I missed that. This would be the hepatic flexure, so this is where the colon turns. And it's on the same side, it's on the side of the liver. So then here we have our transverse colon, then we have our splenic flexure. Then we go down, here's the descending colon, into G, the sigmoid colon, which kind of makes an S. And then that goes down into the rectum. And then I'm trying to see if I can find it. Yep, there would be 32I, that would be the anus. So I've got this thing all like coming apart now. J, 32J, yeah. So each one of these little compartments here is like a house. So it's called hostra. So these are the little sacs there. And then you have this muscle line right here that kind of goes in between all these hostra. And these are called the tenia coli. And so they're what makes these little ridges. Okay, let's see if we can move on to the urinary portion. So 33, here's your adrenal glands, which are sitting right on top of the kidneys. Coming out of each side of the kidney, these are gonna be your ureters. And they are flowing into the urinary bladder, which I believe is labeled on the inside. Yes, labeled on the inside. And then 37, coming out of the bladder, is the urethra. Okay, and lastly, we have the renal artery and the renal vein.